Father is here on this morning. My father, my mom, Adrian, is here on today, and we're grateful to God to have them all the way from Holly Springs, New York. If you ever have any family members or friends, if you have any family or friends who are in the New York area, especially the Queens area, Long Island area, please make sure that you let them know that there's a wonderful ministry on Hollis Avenue in Queens who's doing a great work for God, and God is growing them by leaps and bounds. We're excited. I am honored because if it were not for him, there'd be no me.
Amen.
Many of you are saying, Pastor, we're doing a great job here at Transformation Christian Church, but it is my father that keeps me from going crazy. Y'all ain't talking to me. There is a wonderful bond that he has blessed me to explore in ministry. When people didn't want me to preach, people said I was too young and wasn't ready, he said, no, that's my boy. And he stepped out of faith and licensed to me almost 14 years ago now. And we're grateful to God that he has he's going to preach this morning. I'm going to present this up, introduce this up for others. My father, Pastor James Barnwell, my mother, Baptist Church, Father Stone, New York. Come on, give him a hand this morning, come on, give him a hand. Yes. You may be seated. To God be the glory for the great things he has done. Are you excited to be here this morning?
Yes.
Has God been good to you?
Yes.
Have you brought him from a mighty way? Yes. Oh, give God some glory in the house of God. He is good, God. And worthy to be praised. Amen. 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 We thank the Lord for this opportunity to come and to share here in the great city of Raleigh. And I'm happy to see my son doing the will of the Master. Come on, get Pastor Barnwell a hand of praise today. Amen. That's your pastor. That's your pastor. Give him glory for what the Lord has done. Pastor Barnwell was right. Many thought he was too young to go and serve the Lord, but the Lord had other plans. Amen?
Amen.
That's why we never let anyone stop us from doing what God has laid on your heart. And when he lays something on your heart, you need to go forth in the name of the Lord. So we are proud of him. He is, his ministry and young service to the Lord is traveling throughout the length and breadth of this nation. And so we know that God has great work for transformation to do. We thank the Lord for the band that's here today. We're doing their thing. As Elizabeth Taylor told her third husband, I won't hold you long. Amen. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down. Come on, help me, y'all. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down. Come on, glory, glory, glory. Down. God bless you, may be seated. It's been my understanding your theme this month has been dealing with spiritual warfare. And so we are delighted to touch on this theme and topic today as we endeavor to do the will of the Master. What verse would you like to lift this morning from Ephesians, the 6th chapter, verse 12, for it reads, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." May the Lord have a blessing to hear and read your holy word. May we seek in our minds, hearts, and souls, and come out into everyday walk of life. We want to talk for a little while this morning, wrestling with life's battles. Wrestling with life's battles. Let us bow. Father God, we thank you today for allowing us to come to share here at the Transformation Church. We ask the Lord to bless this preaching moment. We thank you, Lord, for the pastor of this church. We thank you for the saints of God who have assembled. The more of thee, the less of me be seen. In the awesome name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. And thank the Lord for my wife being here this morning. Stand right quick, Sister Adrian. Amen. Wrestling with life's battles. Life is a battle. We wrestle on our jobs. We battle with our friends. We wrestle with relationships. Satan is always on our trail, and we wrestle with him. As we come to lift up the name of Jesus, we understand that life has many challenges, that Satan has its dispatched enemies all around us.
Yeah.
Satan tries to stop us from doing the will of the Master. Paul made it clear that our warfare is not against people, but against spiritual powers that operates in secret places. Therefore, we cannot win spiritual battles with carnal weapons. But we must realize that the real enemy that we fight, we must use spiritual weapons. And that is the word of God. Paul understood this challenge because Paul was called on the Damascus Road. He was called to carry the gospel of Jesus Christ. But on his journey with papers from the high priest, the apostle encountered something on that Damascus Road. I believe it was a transforming experience. In other words, Paul's life was turned around by the mere fact that he encountered the Son of God. Here, what the word says unto us, the Lord speaks to him and saying, "Saul, Saul, why persecutest